Kingdomino Duel, a version of Kingdomino for two players only, but most importantly to me, a version of Kingdomino that is in roll and write format, because this is a style of games that I like very much. They're very portable, and there is just something fun about writing in as part of your game, I guess, writing on your game components. So, style of game that has been very popular, and I'm happy that now there is a version of Kingdomino that plays that way, because I like Kingdomino. Now, let's see how the execution of this promising idea turned out to be. You get a stack of things that you will write on. These are double-sided. On one hand, you have, well, your kingdom, and you will give one such sheet of paper to each player. On the other side, there is the book of spells, which you place in the middle of the table, which means also that once you're done, one of these that you're using here can be used as the new book of spells, or vice versa, no book of spell, like in this case, can be used as a kingdom to save, the book of spell can be used as kingdom to save things, to save a little bit of resources and help the planet. Now, there are these four dice here with various symbols, with coats of arms, some also have hexes, and then we got some question marks that represent wild symbols. They represent any coat of arm you want them to be. The way this works, here on the two sides, you write the names of the two players. In fact, this can be like this, with one side facing one player and the other side facing the other player. Then players will alternate being player A and player B. During a turn, player A rolls the dice and then chooses one die. Then player B will choose two dice, and player A will take the die that is left. Basically, you have to think of these two symbols as the two halves of a domino tile. You are making your domino tile. And suppose, let's say, this is the domino tile that I want to make. Then you will draw it on your board, the following traditional or sort of traditional domino rules. You can place your tile, one of the two spaces adjacent to the castle, which is in the middle of your personal board, and that is regardless of the symbol. Later, you can attach a domino tile only to a symbol that is of the same kind. Suppose, for example, that I decide to start here, so I draw that symbol there, and there's also an X, and then I have this other symbol here, which I produce like so. Now, for each coat of arm that I have in my domino tile that does not have an X, I get to draw an X in the corresponding line on the book of spell, starting from the outside, just like so. If I had a question mark, it would count as a wild coat of arm, but does not produce an X on the book of spell. And suppose my opponent has drawn their things, and then we go again. Now, my opponent is the first player, and my opponent decides to take that one. I'm second player, I take these two. And I decide, again, this time, to build again next to the castle, because I don't have anything that I could place adjacent there. Just like so. Just like so. And I get an X there, and an X in the book of spell, and this line here. One more. I'm first player. This time I decide to take this one. My opponent takes this one and this one and leaves me with these two. Seeing that I'm building a kingdom like this, maybe my opponent would have taken this one just to get out of the way, but luckily enough, he or she was distracted. And actually I decide to use this one as that coat of arm again, and I put it there, which I can because I am adjacent to that two there. Too bad, no hexes. So we continue like this, alternating, and from time to time, players will reach the red space of a line, in which case you strike the corresponding line of the opponent, and the player that got there first gets to take advantage of that ability there. And so there are just different abilities, such as, say, this one, you can place a tile disregarding the usual placement rules. You can break a domino tile into two halves and place them not adjacent to one another. When you're player A, you can take two two dice before the opponent gets the remaining two. You can change the orientation of a die. You can choose one of your domains. We'll see what those are. And each will be worth 3 points at the end of the game. This is very important because domains are usually worth all the points when they are big. This way, you get to score points even if you have a bunch of small domains, as long as they are one kind, even if they're scattered all around. So we continue like this until all tiles, all domino tiles that can be placed are placed. That is to say, and I'm just making up some more symbols to explain final scoring. So basically until either both players are unable to place any more tiles under the point we score, or until a player fills up their kingdom entirely. Then you score domains. A domain is a number of squares on your board adjacent to one another and having the same symbols. So this would be a domain of four like that. This would be this other domain here. This is another one, and this is another one. How many points they're worth? The number of squares in the domain times the number of X's or crosses. So here we have 4 times 1, that is 4 points. This domain has 2 squares, but 0 X's, 2 times 0, 0. Oh, this one had an X, did you see that? Yes, 1 times 1 is 1. This one has 3 squares and 3 X's, 3 times 3 is 9. You count all of those points, you add the possible points for that special way of scoring that may be activated by the Book of Spells, and at the end of that, after you have totaled all the points, the player with the highest score is the winner of the game. So, Kingdomino Duel, certainly very simple, very light, but fun, but pretty entertaining. It has the general core idea of Kingdomino, which I like very much. Roll and write some mechanic or a style that I also like, and the two things go well together. Recently I played games that look like that, looking at the elements, it looked like they couldn't go wrong, and they did. This one doesn't. This one is precisely what it's advertised on the package. Kingdomino, for 2 players only, so there's that limitation maybe, but in a roll and write format, with also some specific advantages. I do not know of other games where you build your own domino tiles, and to me that adds a lot to, well, domino, just like Kingdomino per se, adds to what is otherwise a totally dull and brainless game, in my very humble opinion. So Kingdomino makes domino fun. Here you add another mechanic that just I hadn't seen before, and building your own tiles, that's just fascinating to me. And it does, of course, give you a lot of interesting options, as in so many roll and write games, well, you have to balance the things that you're scoring now, but every time that you put something down, you're committing in that area, and therefore you're trying to keep your options open, or you push your luck a little bit, as you know that by building on certain areas, you're locking out certain things and making it less likely for you to score. So there is that interesting element. The Book of Spells, that is also fun, and it has a nice balance there between the fact that if you're not getting crosses, then it's hard to score, because actually if you have Dominion with no scores whatsoever, that is, with no X's whatsoever, that is a zero. But at the same time, you have a balancing element there due to the fact that you're doing that thing. Also, if you have wild symbols, the question marks, they're super powerful, but they don't give you crosses, and they don't give you anything from the Book of Spell. So the different elements, the different choices that you have, mind you, they're very simple, very linear, but they work, because they result in a game experience that is fun, entertaining. You have things that you are considering, there is enough strategy there to keep you entertained. The fact that you're playing against a single opponent means that you will usually, unless you're sleeping, I guess, have a good sense of what the opponent is doing, and that of course means that you can factor that in. It doesn't become a take that game in the sense that you attack the opponent, but there may be cases where you do take a die because you don't want the opponent to have it, and it's obvious that that is the case. So there's a little bit of confrontational element, but hey, I played the game with my daughter Luisa, who is 7 and does not like confrontations unless she wins. And she was okay with the fact that I was obviously taking dice because I didn't want her to have them. And if Luisa can take it, so can you. Kingdomino Duel, for only 2 people, but small game, travels well, and most importantly, pretty fun.